Some police critics claim that high-speed pursuit syndrome was a factor in a tragic incident that occurred in Orange County, California. On February 14, 1996, several agencies were involved in a pursuit that began when police noticed 27-year-old Hong Il Kim driving erratically. 30 minutes into the chase, it looked like they had Kim trapped. Amazingly, Kim continued to evade arrest. He led officers into a mall parking lot, looking for an escape route. The police knew they had him cornered and moved in, but Kim still would not surrender. Both plainclothes and uniformed officers surrounded the truck to take the suspect in. Boxed in with nowhere else to go, Kim used his vehicle as a battering ram. Confronted with a 4,000-pound weapon, the police found themselves facing an all-too-common dilemma: to shoot or not to shoot.
What's going through your mind is, why is this guy running? What's he done? By the time you've chased him down several streets, you believe this guy is really hot. This guy, he must be a felon, he must be a robber, he must be something. And you're worried whether or not you're going to get involved in a shooting after this pursuit ends.
That's exactly what happened in this case. Police opened fire, killing Kim in a hail of bullets. Four officers fired 30 rounds to stop Kim. Did these officers succumb to high-speed pursuit syndrome? Or did Kim pose a real danger to them once he was boxed in? The officers claimed that they had acted in self-defense when Kim accelerated towards them. Some members of the community, however, saw the shooting as an execution by overexcited police. Kim's family filed a wrongful death lawsuit against the officers, alleging that they had used excessive deadly force. In April 1998, a federal judge dismissed the lawsuit. The court ruled that the actions on the part of the officers had been objectively reasonable and that they had acted in self-defense.